Hello, I'm the great Orbax. I'm here today with Dr. Mike Massa to discuss circular motion.
Okay, so we've been talking about the idea that an object can travel at a constant speed, but because its direction changes, there's going to be an acceleration, and that's the centripetal acceleration. It always points to the center of the circular path. Now, because there's an acceleration, there's a net force, and we might call the tension in the string here, for example, pulling towards the center of the circle as the centripetal force. Let's take a look at an example, but instead of something this aggressive, let's look at the ball spinning. It's still traveling in a circular path, but it's hanging from the rope now. There's still tension, but the tension now is not directed to the center of the path. So to figure out what the centripetal force is here, why don't we draw a free body diagram?
Let's do it.
Okay. All right. Let's take the instance where the ball was coming around here. It's heading away from the camera. The rope is going to be make an angle this way. With some angle theta relative to the vertical, and that's just some tension force T.
And of course, the ball itself actually has a weight associated with it, meaning that you're going to have a force of gravity acting directly down.
With any free body diagram, the goal is to list all the forces acting on the ball. There's just these two. Now, centripetal acceleration, V squared over R, is the response, is the motion, and that's traveling always to the center of the circle. So we could say the centripetal acceleration is pointing in this direction at that instant of time. But now we're done. I mean,
and that's the thing, right? We're looking at literally doing a free body diagram. All we want to discuss is the sum of forces. And in this case, if we just look at the sum of forces in the x direction, it's not equal to zero. It's equal to a mass times an acceleration term, where that acceleration term is that center-seeking acceleration, or that inwards pull.
Right. So in this case, I mean, we would say that T sine theta is acting in the x direction, and that's causing MA, the MV squared over R, centripetal motion.
And that's it. You literally have an acceleration towards the center that's defined by the fact that you have a component of the tension acting in that direction.
There you go. Okay, geez.